Hi there, everyone, and welcome to Me Play Minecraft. First of all, I want to say thank you once again for checking out my videos and supporting the channel. For this Minecraft series, I've played a lot of Minecraft when I was a kid, and I enjoyed it a lot, especially my times in high school. And I kind of wanted to revisit and go back to it. I kind of played with my college server, but I never really got a chance to play by myself, so I'm gonna be exploring the Minecraft after 7 years of not playing it. So this could be mainly relaxing. Just hear me relax, hear me go around the world and tick blocks for the house. I'm gonna be playing hardcore survival because I'm a hardcore guy, so I hope you enjoy. And if you do enjoy my videos, subscribe, like, and leave a comment if anything you enjoyed, and check out my other videos as well. But with that, let's get you comfortable and relax as we play through Minecraft Java Edition Hardcore Survival. I should mention my keyboard that I usually use broke, so this keyboard is going to be a little more silent than usual, so I apologize for that in advance. there's really much for us to do on the first night because everything is so dangerous, so I suppose we can have a conversation about something. For those who don't know anything about Minecraft, this is considered day zero. Day zero is always the longest day in Minecraft. I couldn't tell you what the exact timer is, but it has the longest day and the longest night. Well, I don't know about the longest night, but it definitely has the longest day. And that is specifically designed for anyone, really, because the first day is always the hardest day. You have no equipment. You start off with nothing, and you need to gather yourself some resources so you can survive through the night, because that's when all the monsters and the mobs, the hostile mobs, come out. So you need to be equipped with as much as you can on day zero. That's why they make it so long. So right now, I'm just trying to get myself situated for the next day, because the next day is going to be much more dangerous. There's going to be creepers, spiders, endermen, zombies, skeletons, and some new mobs that I don't really understand. Apparently there's a mob that lives in water and it throws a trident at you. Some crazy stuff. And apparently now there's baby zombies that run really fast. And I've actually fought a couple baby zombies on my school server, and they're tough, I can tell you that. They're fast, and it seems they're more resilient than their adult counterparts, which doesn't make too much sense, but that's okay. And also, a lot of the humanoid mobs tend to have a lot of armor as well. They usually come with armor, enchanted weapons. It's some crazy stuff out there. So right now, I'm just trying to find a way to get to Iron as fast as possible. Because once I have Iron, then that's when the journey really begins. Because then I can safely build myself some armor. And then I can be less worried about dying. Because as you may or may not know, in hardcore, you only get one chance to live. So I have to be as careful as I can. Thank you. course, I'm going to conclude this session for today. We definitely got a lot done in 2 days. We got pretty lucky with the iron spawn, so we're fully suited up. The next time, we're going to prepare more for the eventual expedition to find diamonds. And then, you know, obsidian, the end, blah, 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 blah. All that's good stuff. So, thank you guys for listening and watching. I hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you guys next time.